आई रवि रंजन तिवारी टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू यूनिट थर्ड चैप्टर द लिटिल गर्ल फॉर क्लास नाइन्थ. दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर यू. इन दिस चैप्टर यू फाइंड द रिलेशन बिटवीन पेरेंट्स एंड द चिल्ड्रन. दिस इज अ स्टोरी अबाउट द चेंजिंग एटीट्यूड ऑफ ए गर्ल चाइल्ड टुवर्ड्स हर फादर. इन दिस स्टोरी डू यू नो अबाउट द रिलेशन बिटवीन पेरेंट्स एंड चिल्ड्रेन. डू यू फील यू नो योर पेरेंट्स बेटर नाउ देन when you were much younger, and perhaps you now understand the reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. This story about a little girl whose feeling for her father changing from fear to understanding will probably found an echo in every home. You know about the Catherine Mansfield was a great English writer, and he wrote about the real condition of a real society. And through this story, Catherine Mansfield wanted to express about the general feeling of children and the parents. First, I want to read out some stanza, then I elaborate these lines. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss, to which she responded with goodbye, father, and oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of the carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. In the evening, when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall. Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet, mother? Go and see if my papers are out there. And bring me my slippers. Through these lines, writer wanted to describe about the attitude of father, and the little girl expresses her feelings towards her father. The little girl, here he means father. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. And little girl found an avoided and feared figure to her father. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss. It is the daily routine of her father. When her father go out from his house, then he came to meet her little girl and gave her a casual kiss, to which she responded with goodbye, father, and oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of carriage growing fainter and fainter down the long road. When his father go out from the house and she heard the voice of carriage became fainter and fainter, and it is the moment of her relief. In the evening, when her father came from, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud fire in the hall. And his father ordered her mother and the other family members, "Someone brings me tea." And he wanted paper, daily paper, and mother, "Go and see if my papers out there and bring me my slippers." These are the daily routine of her father. And when that little girl faces this routine, and she was very feared and avoided his attitude. The next standard, Kezia, mother would call to her, "If you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boot." Slowly the girl would slip down the stair, more slowly still across the hall, and push upon the drawing room door. Her mother announced her name, Kezia, and mother would call to her, "And if you are a good girl," and mother addressed me, "If you are a good girl, you just come down and take off father's boots." And very slowly that little girl would slip down the stairs, more slowly see across the hall and push open the drawing room door. And she found by that time her father had his spectacles on and looked at her over them in a way that was terrifying the little girl. The figure of her father is very terrifying the little girl, and she was very afraid to meet her father. "Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside. Have you been a good girl today?" And her father said to her little girl, Kezia, "Hurry up and pull off these boots and do your work very sincerely like a good girl." And Kezia was not able to respond very simply her father's behavior, and she said, "I don't know, father," means you don't know. If you stutter like that, mother will have to take you to the doctor. Kezia was not able to express her feeling in a very clear way, so her sound is stuttered. And father also repeated in his own voice the sound of Kezia. This attitude of a parent towards the children is not very good, and children were not able to understand the real attitude of the parents. And I suggested the students, please read out this chapter very carefully and try to understand. And next class, I continue my lecture. Today I stop.